Hi, friends, and welcome to another edition of Keeping Up with the Jackrabbits. I'm Tyler Merriam. Great to have you with us, and great to be joined by one of the all-time greats in Jackrabbit football lore, Taryn Christian. TC, how are you?
I'm doing great. Thanks for having me.
Well, thank you for being a part of this. I would like to just take a step back and find out what your thoughts are at the moment, because you were optimistic to be playing in the Canadian Football League at this point in time, but as we found out, there will be no CFL, just like there won't be a Jackrabbit football season in 2020. So what are your thoughts at this time?
Obviously just bummed not to be able to get up there and meet some new teammates. Just kind of enjoy a new culture, play a new kind of game and style of football. Wanted to just be able to play again. I've kind of been out for a year. Didn't get any game action last year. Looking forward to maybe getting a chance to see the field a little bit this year and then just kind of see where it goes from there. But you got to do what you got to do as far as keeping everybody safe right now, in these crazy times. So there's really nothing I can do about it. Just control the things that I can control and just keep on keeping on here.
Speaking of controlling the things you can control, how have you stayed not only in shape physically, but also just keeping your arm ready, keeping yourself mentally ready to play the game of football when, like you said, you haven't been able to have some of those reps over the last year?
Right. So I've been working out at kind of two different places. The Power Shop gym here in Brookings, I've been working out there. I was working out with Mikey Daniel and Luke Sellers for a while, but now they finally got to go off to training camp and everything, so really excited for them. And then I've been going down to Sioux Falls and throwing at the Sanford Fieldhouse with Curtis Riggs, who kind of did my training last year, and then we've kind of continued on with him this year. So been blessed with that those two facilities opened up, been able to get there and stay in shape that way.
So aside from staying in shape, I know you're playing golf every now and again. What else is keeping Taryn Christian busy these days?
So I work full time. I actually work here. I work at Dunham Sporting Goods here in town. And then really just golfing, working out. My days are usually pretty full, actually. So I usually am at work about eight hours a day, then either go work out, go throw. I've gone fishing. My landlord is actually Mason Lyseth. So I actually go hunting and fishing and do all that with him and then go golfing with some other guys. So.
And then, oh, by the way, we're planning for a wedding as well, right?
Yes, we are planning for a wedding. It's going to be May 1st next year. It's going to be in Sioux Falls. Real excited for that. It's going to be a special day. Real excited for that to come.
I think most Jackrabbit fans are aware, but for those who don't, it is Taryn and Taggin Larson, Taryn Christian. Now, you have a unique first name, and so does she, and you have one letter that separates the two. For some reason, me being the word person that I am just finds that fascinating.
Yeah, a lot of people have, and a lot of people kind of get a kick out of it whenever we, like, introduce ourselves. They're like, how do you spell that? And it's just, yeah, it's the same, just R and a G is different. Whenever we do our name change, it'll be pretty similar. So
how did you two meet?
We met in high school. It was our sophomore year in high school. Well, we went to middle school together too, but we didn't really hang out too much. And then sophomore year, I just kind of, took a shot in the dark, went for it. And we ended up here today. So, it's been great. It's been a lot of fun. She's really fun, to be around and just, just kind of lost for words.
Well, certainly she is fun. Anybody who's paid attention to the videos that we've done over the past year with the women's basketball team with tagging on the road, stealing the show, is well aware of that. But tell me about the athletic competitions between future husband and future wife. You know, you get on the golf course ever, or you ever shoot hoops. I know you're a better football player, but I want to know about the other stuff.
They're actually few and far in between. I get pretty dang competitive when we start doing stuff, and she'll kind of get frustrated with me sometimes. So one of the big things we have every year at the 4th of July at my aunt's cabin, we have this big thing. It's a family Olympics. It gets really competitive. I get really serious. Tegan tells me to calm down, and I don't want to calm down. But other than that, kind of just, she'll go golfing with me every once in a while, kind of go fishing, random things. We actually played a lot of tennis during quarantine. So kind of just random things. But when we do that, it's really not, you know, one-on-one, I'm going to beat you. It's more just kind of having fun hanging out.
Now, we joke about the wedding planning side of it, but are you involved much? Because is tagging taking the lead on this, I would assume?
We're pretty even right now. I'm pretty laid back as far as what I want. She's a little bit more specific with things that maybe like decorations, something like that. I think we are going to have an ice sculpture, though. I did want one of those. The venue we chose, they do that. So I think we're going to get something going that way. But other than that, we picked out a venue together, did all that. We got our like colors and everything that we're going to have. So now we're kind of in the process of, well, she's going to get a dress. I've got to get the suits fitted and get all that, get all our invitations out and everything like that. So,
all right, let's shift gears and talk a little football. How much do you stay in contact with the guys currently in the program? Are you still working as a mentor to them at times? Are you trying to just kind of be at a distance? How do you handle that right now?
A little bit of a distance, kind of, you know, it's their own journey. If they ever have questions, of course, happy to help. Ran into Jabore around a little bit. I ran into like Cannon Nelson, Keaton Heidi a little bit. Don't know if I've seen any of the new guys, but, and then at Dunham's, actually, a lot of them come through there picking up random stuff. So whenever I see guys around, you know, I'll say what's up to them. But it's their own journey. They're going to be on it, their own team, things like that. You know, I'm not necessarily around the culture of the team anymore, so you kind of miss that feel and things like that. But, you know, they're going to do great things. I'm excited to watch them when we do get to watch some football again.
What were your emotions when you found out last fall that College Game Day was coming to Brookings and South Dakota State?
I was happy and upset at the same time, because I was like, dang, I would have loved to be a part of that. But I think it just speaks to kind of the guys that have went through and kind of just really the history of the program just keeps building up really every year. And you know, of course the ultimate goal is just to break through and get to Frisco and bring home a national championship. But to have things like that, College Game Day, it just shows, you know, the program you're building, that's been built and is, you know, still continuing on. It's pretty special, and pretty proud to be a part of it.
I was just going to say, you must take a lot of pride in seeing where the program was when you first got on campus to where it is now, to things like College Game Day, to have played such a large role in helping take this program from a good one to obviously one of the elite in the FCS.
Yeah, absolutely. And we always talked about, you know, raising the level of expectations every year in our preseason meetings, especially, you know, there's a new bar being set. As far as where we wanted to be, our vision for the year, things like that. My freshman year, it was kind of, you know, be a top 8 seed. Next year, it was be a top 4 seed. And then it was really top 2, and then win a national championship my senior year. And really, that was the one we didn't get to, unfortunately, but hopefully they do here soon. But, you know, take a lot of pride in that stuff, and, you know, growing and being a part of where the just program has gone to today.
Best Stig story.
Man, I haven't thought about this in a while. His just anytime he says holy nutmeg, is just, you know, it's pretty iconic. And it's his Twitter handle and everything. So that's pretty fun. But I do remember somebody made fun of him for, he takes notes at like everything, like no matter what it is. It can be a team meeting, practice. I don't know if he's sitting having coffee with his wife in the morning. He's probably taking notes about it or something. But he takes notes about everything. And someone called him out in their senior speech and kind of made fun of him. And Stig didn't really know what to say back to it. So it was pretty funny. That's one that always just kind of sticks out in my mind.
I thought you were going to say as he was being made fun of, he started making notes about being made fun of.
He probably did. I guarantee he was. He wrote that down.
Well, Taryn, we could chat all night, but appreciate the time. Wish you nothing but the best. And if anybody needs an autograph, I guess Dunham's is the place to go for that.
Absolutely. I'd be happy to do it.
Taryn, thanks for the time. He's Taryn Christian. I'm Tyler Merriam. Thanks for joining us on Keeping Up with the Jackrabbits.